So, I've got 300. So my first equation is always just add the two things together, set them equal to how many there are. Nothing too bad. The second equation is going to be the costs that go with each one. So I'm still going to have a D. I'm going to put a little space in here on purpose. I'm still going to have a V. Okay, how much does a single DVD cost? 25. Ooh, some high-priced stuff. So I put the price in front of how many I'm selling. So to figure it out, price times quantity, 25 times D. Okay. So once I have that, then what we're going to do is we're going to do the same thing for the video. So how much do those cost? How much does each video cost? 15. Focus. I have a lesson. We've got important things to do. Okay? And then how much total do all these DVDs and videos cost? A whole bunch. Okay? So if I were going to try and do this, I'd have to multiply my first equation by the 25. I'd flip those. But for right now, I just want to get you in the mode of attempting to set these up. Because if you aren't, are you simple? Okay. Because my second equation is how much each item costs, and then the total amount that it makes at the end is going to be what it sets it equal to. Okay? So, but all we're doing on here is setting these up. Okay? And after that, we keep it fairly simple. So then next, we're going to do the same thing on the next one. The speech we just gave, we've got to stay focused on things. We're not focused and on the... I'm not going to play games quiet. Okay. Second one, we're going to do the same thing. What are our two different things that we're working with? Yes, sir? Sure.
Are you writing about the other?
The first time, no. If you start doing it on a daily basis, we'll have to talk about what we can do, but... So, what are our two separate things? Okay? We're traveling by car, we're also traveling by train. We're always looking for those two separate things. So here, C would be when I'm going by a car. T would be when I'm going by a train. So once I get that part, I'm going to use this kind of as my example. How long am I going to end up traveling? 50 hours, okay? So what's my first equation going to be? Let me do this. Maybe this will help a little bit. If I'm doing part by the number of hours I'm traveling in a car, and part with what I'm doing hours in a train, we just said total it's going to be 50. So C plus T is going to be 50. And then the second one, okay, how far total am I going to be traveling? 3,510. So that'll be my equal for the second one. So to figure out this part, I got to figure out how fast I'm traveling with each one. So my car, how fast am I going in the car? 65. And what about the train? Okay.
Can you do by tomorrow?
That'd be nice. Yeah, that's okay.
Oh, you already sent me the ISS?
Again, we're just getting setup done on these. So we're not trying to do anything fancy. We're just trying to say, can we get them ready so when it is time to actually start doing something, we can do it. So on the next one, what two different things am I working with? See, we're always going to find this stuff out early. Cheaper tickets and more expensive tickets. $1 and $5 tickets. Now, this one's a little trickier. What labels do you want to use? What variables? And it doesn't matter which one. What's that? Okay. R my one. Okay. So that's my number of $1 ticket. And then say okay. And you can use any letter you want. If you want to use your initials for the two, you know, variables, that's fine. So again, my first one is always just going to be add the two variables. So if I have a certain number of $1 tickets and a certain number of $5 tickets, how many total tickets did I sell? 502, because we're just doing the number of the tickets the first time. Now, on the second one, when we start adding the prices in, how much, well, this is kind of a silly question to ask, how much does a $1 ticket cost? A dollar. How much does a $5 ticket cost? Five. But how much total did I make from ticket sales? 890. Okay, so that would be my equation that I was working with. So you start to see some consistency. You're like, oh, so the amounts go in the second one, and you just add them up for a total in the first. And that's exactly what we're doing. Right now, we're just setting them up. We'll start solving them, but I want to get the first part down before we start worrying about the solving part. Office building, 332 offices. Okay, that doesn't tell me enough yet. Smaller offices and larger ones. Okay, those are my two different things. Okay, I got small offices, and I have large ones. So look at the information that you're given, and let's try to figure out what that first equation is going to be. Use your other first equations as an example. What's your first equation going to look like in this one? Take a chance. Take a risk. What do you think the first equation is going to be? Okay. All right. S plus L is 332. The number of small offices plus the number of large offices equals the total number of offices, which is 332. Good. So then we start putting, now, how big is a small office? 250. So 250 times the number of small offices plus, how big is a large one? 400. And how many total square feet do we have? 100,850. Okay? These are actual applications that can be used to try and figure out, you know, how much money you're making, how many offices would be better to break my building up into. This is what business owners have to think about with these. Well, let's do a little more setup here on the back. And we'll actually solve a couple once we get back here. Actually, we'll try solving five here. Let me grab a seat so I can get in here a little better. So, let's see. When we take a look at number five, there we go. Okay. S would be my number of students. I'm with you. I'm in. A would be the number of adults. All right. We got this. What's my first equation going to look like? Okay. Number of students plus number of adults equals 100. That's how many tickets I sold. So if I add up my students and adults, I should get that's equal. And then I put the values in the second one. So what value goes with my student ticket? $3. 3S. What about the adults? 5. Right there. And how much money did I take in total? $360. Now, this time we're actually going to solve one so you can see how this works. Remember, if I don't see a number in front of my S and my A, it's like having a 1 there. So, if I, let's say, wanted to cancel out students, if this is positive 3, what number do I want this to be? Negative 3. Well, that's a good guess. So I'm just going to multiply by negative 3. The nice thing with these is the first equation is always going to be what I multiply by. So I'm not going to have to get cute. So here, I'm going to come down here because I kind of ran out of room over here. I'm going to multiply that negative 3 all the way through. So negative 3s, negative 3 times 1 would be negative 3a, negative 3 times 100 is negative 300. Okay, but I leave the bottom one alone. So when I go to add them together then, once I have that ready to roll, my S's will cancel, okay, and that'll happen with my first variable as long as I'm solving that. Negative 3 plus 5 would be 2A. Negative 300 plus 360 is 60. I have one step left. Okay, and that's to divide. So divide by 2, in case some of you can't see that towards the back here, we're just dividing by 2. So I know I have 30 adult tickets. So the last little part here, and it's going to be a simple one, if student plus adult tickets is 100, I know that there are 30 adults, so I plug that in for A. I have a one-step equation and I'm done. I mean, it looks so nasty at the start. And my two numbers add up to 100, so I'm pretty confident that I've done this right. But the actual solving of these isn't going to change at all. Okay? All right, let's see here. Let's set one more of these up. Let's take a peek at 7. We'll work one more completely through, and then I will help on some of the on-your-own ones here. All right, we got a money jar containing nickels and quarters worth $1.55. All right. So we've got nickels. We have quarters. So let's see. I know my first equation is going to be n plus q, but is it going to equal $1.55 or 11? 11, because it's the number of what I have the first time, not the value. So my second equation, I have to put values with things. So we got to think about this for a second. How do I write down the value of a nickel as a decimal? We'll come back. What about a quarter? 0.25. So now let's come back. What about the nickel again here? Okay, 0.05. So when I go to make my equation, what I'm going to do, wait, please, and thank you. The price of a nickel goes with nickel. How much a quarter's worth goes with the quarter. And then the amount of money I have comes in at the end. This one's the note sheet. We're going to work on some of the homework in just a second. And then again, these you should like because there's not going to be a whole lot of thinking process. This is 0.05, so I want the top one to multiply by negative 0.05 because then my first variable is going to cancel out. And it'll always work this way for us. So when I multiply through the top one here, and again, everything gets multiplied by that. Let's see here. Again, I mean, definitely need use of the calculator working on this one. So I multiply through the 0.05, the negative 0.05, by all three parts. I'm going to leave that bottom one alone. Doing these may even help some of you if you decide to do a retake on that last quiz to make it go really well. Because now that I multiply by that first number, by its negative to get rid of it, they're going to cancel. A quarter minus a nickel gives me 20 cents. $1.55 minus 55 cents gives me a dollar. And how many 20 cents are in a dollar? I believe that would be 5. And then again, that first equation is going to be always your simplest way to go on these. So here, if n plus q is 11, I know what q is, so n plus 5 equals 11, just subtract the 5. But if keeping that same format, you need to keep the sheets out when you're trying these. It at least gives you a chance on being able to get them set up and kind of take us to that next step. So, once we get out of here, here's what I'll do with you. Let me switch over. Okay, again, note sheet. Now this is the homework assignment. Now we're going to start with some simpler ones and kind of build. So like on this first page, and I believe, let me take a peek here quick. Yeah, I've got a lot of them that are like this. So you're like, okay, you have two numbers. Two numbers. Whenever I see this, I'm just going to call it X and Y. You can call it any two variables you'd like. I have two numbers that add to 25. Okay, let me stop there. What would that equation look like? X plus Y equals 25. Okay. But I also have two numbers that subtract equal 1. So what would that look like? Okay, x minus y, since I'm subtracting, equals 1. Here's the nice thing about this. If I add down, do I eliminate a variable? Yeah. Because now, 1x and 1x is 2x. Yep, we're solving these. Positive 1y and a negative 1y cancel. 25 plus 1 is 26. I'm down to a one-step equation to get this first one already. And that one step's going to be to divide. And I get... Absolutely. And I get my x value. Now, don't stop, though, because I got to know what x and y are. So let me kind of give myself a wall here. Let's say I take the first equation, which was x plus y equals 25. Well, I know what x is. Okay? X is 13. What's my one step to get y by itself? What's the opposite of adding 13 to something? Let's just subtract it. I'm done. See, I didn't even have to multiply anything this time. And my two equations on all of these, you have two numbers, will be x plus y equals something, minus y equals something. And it works the same way. So let's see, that would be 1, 2 works the same way, 3 works the same way. Let's see, what else here? 4 works the same way, and 7, and 8. I put a lot of those in. So let's find one that doesn't. Let's, like, number 5. All right. In one day, a store sells 80 hamburgers and cheeseburgers. All right. Which is going to be my hamburgers? What's that? I suppose. They're just a grocery store. They're just selling the frozen ones. So, we got our number of hamburgers, our number of cheeseburgers. Now, this is running more like what we were doing in the examples for the note sheet. I know it's going to be H plus C, but what's it equal? 80. That's how many hamburgers and cheeseburgers I said. So now we got to put values with our variables. So first I see H there. So how much is a hamburger? $2. 2H. What about the cheeseburgers? 3. And how much cash did I take in? $190. Now, if I just add it down this time, it doesn't quite work as well for me. So I got one thing I have to do. Yep, this is 2H, so I want this to be negative 2. So that's what I'm going to multiply through by. Okay, and all the way through. This time I got room. So I got a negative 2H, negative 2C, negative 160. I just multiplied negative 2 times everything I saw there in that first equation. I leave the second one alone. Negative 2 and positive 2 cancel. That's a good thing. Negative 2 plus 3 is 1C. Oh, that's even better. I'm not going to have a second step on this one. This will be done. Negative 6, 160 plus 190. I have 30 cheeseburgers, but I want to know how many hamburgers there are, too. So I'm going to take that first equation. That's the easy one to work with. hamburgers plus cheeseburgers, but I know cheeseburgers. That's 30. All I got is one step. And I'm telling you, y'all are capable on this. You have got this. Between the ones that we were doing before and the ones that are going on here, okay, at the very least, here's what I'd ask of you. If nothing else, set up the equations like we did on the notes, and if you don't get to solving all of them, let's at least get the equations set up. That's something we can build from. If we have nothing, that's kind of hard to build from. We can always fix something, but we can't fix nothing. And then we're going to go consistent. We're going to be doing this tomorrow. We're going to be doing this Tuesday when you get back. Might even do it Wednesday when you get back. I'm not sure yet. But we're really going to pound home this whole setting up and solving thing. So give yourself the best chance available.